Hi, everyone. Thank you, Jacob, for joining me today for this conversation. I know we just jumped off of Clubhouse talking about, you know, really kickstarting. Today's section was really kickstarting our 6-week, 12 session that we're doing under for new realtors, marketing and mindset. So really, let's dive in. And I want, you know, we came together to do this YouTube session, the Zoom session, so that we can kind of talk about some of this, summarize some of the things we talked about in Clubhouse, make sure that we're bringing value to anyone that's watching that could have missed out. You know, Clubhouse is for iPhone users only. So I want this to make sure, yeah. And again, folks, for those that are watching and you want to get more of this content right after our Clubhouse conversation, we do a wrap up like this. So if you want to get more information in the description, we're going to add a link. Please send us your information and we'll send you a link to this video every time we launch. So Jacob, let's jump into it. So today's conversation for new realtor marketing and mindset, we had, you know, we spoke about a topic, finding your purpose. And let's talk about why we chose that topic first.
Really, I think everybody always comes at us asking for what are you doing? Why is what you're doing working? And I think a lot of people, even when they get that information, it's never going to work for them, right? Because it's not, the secret sauce is in knowing what you're doing, why you're doing it, and just getting stuff done. So I think before we talk about lead generation, we talk about what brokerage should you choose? Because at this point, it doesn't matter, right? Because you don't even know your purpose. You don't know who you are. You don't know your why. So in order for everything else that we're going to go through to work, then we need to tackle the big, which is what people don't like to tackle because it causes us to focus on ourselves. And so I think that's why we started with it, is just so that we can help people be successful with everything else we're giving them.
Absolutely. And, you know, we talked about this a few minutes ago. It's a topic that nobody wants to talk about because there's that fear. And that was one of the topics, is that there's a fear of really, you know, confronting the fear that we have of ourselves, but the fear that is built in the industry as well, right? So I'm really glad that we dived into this. And I know we didn't have, you know, this is one of the rooms that we didn't have as big of an audience as we would have had if it was lead gen, you know, the ones that I've ran in the past before. So it's really interesting. People often jump. And that's one of the topics that I really liked about today, the Shea Hillenbrand. So let's talk about our guest before I jump into some of the topic, is we had Shea Hillenbrand. He is a real estate agent based in Arizona. He is a two-time MLB All-Star. And we had, honestly, we had the honor of having him, and he's someone who embodies, who understood really he found and understood the meaning of life. He found his purpose. And now he's onto the stage of giving that away to people and showing people how he found it. And I love that he's in that stage of his life. And, you know, I love that we talked about with him, you know, all the things he learned to getting here. He's someone who truly, you know, I talked to him about this, and he's someone who lived a dream that so many people dream of. He lived it. He had it all, you know, and he had it all, and he felt empty. And he was a business person, you know, and he is now starting his career in real estate. And he feels like now he's at a place where it's not about real estate for him, but he's in this game is so that he can work with new realtors. And that's why he was that perfect person for us to bring up in this part of our session. And right at the beginning is to confront our fears. Right, is to talk about this important topic of finding out why we're in this industry, and then to really move towards finding different strategies that could work for us. But this is the most, sorry, my little baby woke up.
It's all right, added audience.
Absolutely, my husband's helping out. But you know, that's why I wanted to really jump into this. So right off the bat, I'm going to share some of the things that I found really interesting about today that I learned, and that I really want people to kind of to share some of the things that we talked about today is to me is figuring out. And it goes back to the topic of today is when you're talking about purpose, what does that entail? And how does one arrive at finding a purpose? And that's by looking in. And it's about the stories, like Shea said, it's about the stories we tell ourselves. Mm-hmm. And often, you know, we don't have if people can hear some of the stories we hear about to ourselves, and if there was a mic, it's not good. And often some of the fears we have, and you and I talked about this, is we have this fear of, really, I love how you put it today, you know, and I want you to talk about this right now, about the fear of succeeding. And it's really not about the fear of starting. It's not about the fear of becoming something, but it's really about we get caught up in really not truly understanding who we are. And that's why I love the topic for today.
Yeah, I mean, that whole thing I talked about, people being scared of succeeding. There's a great book called Best Self, and I can't remember his name right now, but he is promoted by Dr. Phil. But my family actually got me this book, and I'm the one that will always talk myself down. I won't give myself enough credit. And it's about being the best version of yourself. And a lot of people don't succeed just because they're scared. Is what happens now? I actually did it, right? Now I got to keep it going. And in the back of your mind is, we don't realize how powerful our subconscious is, right? We do a lot of tasks every day that we don't realize we do. Breathing, we're on autopilot. There's a lot of times I drive 30 minutes and I'm like, oh, how did I get here? You know, it's because you just autopilot everything. And a lot of times we tell ourselves no or talk us out of doing something without even realizing we're doing it, right? And yeah. A lot of it is because if we succeed, now it's on us, right? If we didn't succeed, we can always blame the brokerage, right? Oh, yeah. They didn't give me enough leads, or they didn't train me. But we are in a Google society where you can find any answer for anything. I don't wait around for an answer. And I think that's what separates me. But one thing I had to look at is, it is scary to say, okay, what if I do succeed and I got to keep this business going? What if I fail these clients and then I get a bad review or a bad reputation? Guess what? It's on me now. I can't blame anybody else, right? And we're in a very big blame society today. So I think a lot of people need to take a look at and analyze, like, what am I really scared of? And I think a lot of people just don't know themselves. And it's about learning who you are every day. That's why self-help industry is like a $1 billion industry. It's because people are broken, right?
Yeah.
And so people don't realize, no matter what sales you go into, if you do like multi-level marketing or any type of sales type stuff, right? The number one thing they teach you is to focus on yourself, you know, setting goals. That all has to do with us. So I think that's why I think that's a huge topic.
Yeah, no, I love that. And one of the things you talked about right now, it's, you know, keeping yourself accountable. And I know we had a guest that came up and talked about, how do you find a mentor? Where do I begin? And I love Shea jumped in and said, what do you need help with? And, you know, again, right. Going back to yourself, going back to, you know, you can't find a mentor who's going to be the person that does everything for you. You don't go to a mentor to help you with babysitting and cooking and cleaning, right? You often go to someone to help you with maybe one aspect of your career, another aspect of your career. You know, I have a mentor for my marketing career. I have a mentor for my real estate transaction, because they may not be good at both, or, right, finding strengths. And I think, and just because you've been a professional in a certain industry doesn't make you a certain expert. It doesn't, there's a lot to learn. And so that's why I love when that person jumped and said, hey, I'm looking for a mentor, where do I begin? And that accountability starts with you. And you can't put that accountability on anyone else but you. And that's why I love when somebody brings that up. And you know, even Shay said that too. We were so caught up and often going so far ahead, you know, with our life, that we often focus so much on the destination, right? We talk about the end goal, and which is very important, because, you know, this in marketing, that's the first thing I do when I sit with people. Where do you want to get to? What is your vision? What is your mission? What's your purpose? And often we forget about the process in between. Truly, Jacob, you know, the journey is everything, you know, in life, right? The journey is everything, that we have to fulfill it and we enjoy it. We have to enjoy it at the best of our ability. And often we get so caught up in getting somewhere that we don't enjoy the in between, and learning in between, and giving back in the in between. So I love, you know, when you talk about accountability, it's really putting that onuses on oneself, on ourself. And, you know, and this is not just in as a realtor, like in my relationship with my husband, you know, doing dishes. Sometimes like, hey, did you forget to do the dishes? And he often, why we make such a good partner is we just jump in and we just do it and we help each other out. And not that I forgot to do it. It's more like, instead of calling another person out, he just does it. I do it. We help each other out. And I think that's what life is about, is the synergies and these beautiful things that come out of this, is because it all starts with us and our thoughts, the stories we tell ourselves, and keeping each other accountable. Is there something else that, you know, in today's conversation that jumped out at you?
It's just along the same topic. I love, because this is not a new topic, right? We hear this all the time and people try to dodge it, and you just can't get away from it until you finally give into it, right? And we're all going through this journey. I love what you said, like, you know, we're always so focused on the end, right? I'm a big picture guy.
Yeah.
I partner well with people, even though they drive me crazy, that I want to know every little step, but I need them because they can't see the big picture, but I can. So I need to know how to get there, right? And so I can use them for those things. And with technology now, I mean, we have become such a Google it society where we want to know the end result, right? We want to know, oh, how do I get there and what are the bumps along the way? I mean, look at traffic nowadays. It gives you 3 traffic routes and says, this one's less busy. There's a toll road here.
Yeah.
So you already know what you're going to run into before you start. So, and life isn't that way. And I think a lot of people have taken themselves out, especially with everything we've gone through with this pandemic, that a lot of people have just stopped enjoying the journey, right? And so a lot of times we just got to take that one step, take the next one. And it's okay not to know what's ahead. And I think that's where a lot of people, when Shea was talking about, you know, you got to have a system and an accountability and start at level 1, then 2, not level 1, then 8. And then, okay, let me go back to 2 because I thought I could skip it, right?
Yeah.
And sometimes, you know, in your interview with him, he said, sometimes you get to level 4 and it bumps you down to level 2. But guess what? When you get to level 4 again, or you get to that area, you're just going to kind of jump over it because you've already done it, right? And I think that when we get into that thinking that we're just going to go step by step, and it's okay not to know. And the best thing that I love that he said, especially as an athlete, which is kind of contradictory to an athlete's lifestyle, is he said, it's okay to fail, right?
Yeah.
Failing's good. We're taught failing is bad, right? And we're taught stories by our parents, and, you know, you're a product of your environment, but then I believe that you're not, because, right, you're a product of your environment, but at some point you have to take responsibility. And that's what people are scared of, because you take responsibility for somebody else's stuff, but you don't want to take responsibility for your own, right?
Absolutely.
As a kid, we always try to blame somebody else.
Yeah. And
it just goes into an adult. So to hear him talk about those things, and that you're responsible for yourself, and if you fail, it's on you, and it's okay to fail. And one quote I like that I used it the other day was, there was a, when they interviewed Thomas Edison, who invented the light bulb, they said, what was it like to fail 1,000 times? And he said, it wasn't a failure. It was a 1,000 step process to inventing the perfect light bulb, right? And so that's what the journey we're on. And that's why we created this room for new realtors and then marketing. But before you do the marketing, you got to have the right mindset, right? You got to know how you're going to overcome all those no's. You're going to play the number game, because that's what it is. At the end of the day, it's sales. And, you know, focus on new realtors, because we can get them in the right mindset in the first 90 days, 6 months of their first year. They're going to continue on, and they're not going to fail, especially with the statistic that you gave with NAR saying 87% of realtors, what? Fail, right?
Yeah.
In their first 5 years. So only 13% of people are succeeding. And then Shea gave a statistic that said 95% of realtors in their first year fail, which is a huge number. And then NAR reporting that all the transactions that are done, that are reported, only 10% come from realtors, from their membership. So only 10% of people are producing, making such huge numbers. What's happening to everybody else? And it all comes back to this topic.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And, you know, I was just talking to another realtor who was in our room today. He messaged me right after, and we were talking about, because he was asked about lead gen. And I said, I can give you 100 lead gen ideas right now. I can give you 100 lead gen ideas. Super easy. That's no problem. But it always comes back to taking action and being consistent and be committed to that process. And I know it's ugly, and we've been there. Jacob, you and I talk about this on a daily basis. How many times have we gone back and forth saying, you know, but it's funny, from the beginning of what I started doing, I tweaked a little bit of my process, but I haven't quite changed. And you know, and I'm seeing more and more results, and it's because we built a solid foundation, right? And we're both new real estate agents. We haven't been in the game for a really long time, but we're taking massive action. We're committed to the process, and we're seeing tons of results. And yeah, it doesn't happen overnight. And you know, and some of the results aren't you know, closing and capping right away, and it's okay. But we're attracting clients, we're working with clients, we're building a powerful brand, but they'll all come with a process and being realistic about this process, right? And what I really wanted to talk about too is that we often get, you know, the purpose is one thing, you know, that we talked about today. Purpose is one thing, keeping yourself accountable, moving past that fear, but then aligning yourself with the right people to get there. And, you know, I had an agent that messaged me and said, you know, why did you choose this brokerage and such? And I, you know, what worked for me may not work for you, you know? So go back to, again, it's going back to your purpose. You know, are you looking for a brokerage that is going to be, you know, who's going to train you such and such way? Are you looking to make this a part-time, full-time? Are you looking for a certain income? Are you looking for long-term wealth out of this job? Are you going to go in it full-time, make it your end-all, be-all? You know, and your marketing plan, your business plan, all of that really changes. And the people you align yourself with, and somebody says, oh, a lot of people from this brokerage approached me. And I said, great. But it's on you to question those people and ask them, what kind of value are you going to give me to help me get to my goal and my purpose? So if you don't align yourself with the right people to get there, and that's what I love working with you, Jacob, is you and I, when we talk, right? When we talk, there's an energy, we click, we get it. We talk about, we're on the same language and same plane, and we're honest with each other, right? And we're honest about our successes. We're honest about why we're working together. You know, we talked about this. There's no monetary, you know, gain from us working together right now. But there's a lot of things that I'm learning working with you, right? But why is that? Because I and you were open to accepting new opportunities. I am not afraid of you, Jacob, as my competitor. No, because I'm here to learn from you, right? And I think, and the value that you bring to this relationship, and we demand that out of each other. And there's a point that it might not work and we're gonna go our separate ways, but that's on us to be accountable to that process and to say, you know what, this is working and this isn't, but you know what, it hasn't been perfect, but I got a lot out of this and so did you. And, you know, and so that's why it's really important to go back to the people that you align yourself with. And, you know, I was talking to one of the agents who's on my team, and she's came from KW and she was with them for a year. She had zero deals. And I went back to her and I said, to be honest, and I was super frank. And I said, I'm going to push you and we're going to get there. And what is your goal? What is your purpose? What do you want to do? And we're going to do a lot of deals. We're going to kick ass because that's what you want. But remember, KW gave you that too, but you didn't accept those opportunity. And yeah, they didn't give you leads like I am. I know they're not giving you type of marketing consultation like I am, but, and yes, they weren't committed to working with you in the way that I am, but remember, you got to help yourself to accept these opportunities because they have kick-ass training, right? A lot of brokerages have a lot of good training, but again, how do you use these training, right? Resources, like you said, we're literally steps, like clicks away from all the strategies in the world, right? But anyways, but I can keep going, but jump in.
It's right. I mean, look at the industry right now, especially with the pandemic happening. They're saying that the new online education system is a $1 trillion industry, right? So many people offering courses. You can get a course anywhere. I mean, look at, I think it's Udemify or... there's an online course. I'm drawing a blank right now. Literally, like, I wanted to learn about cryptocurrency. I found a course for $12. Like, and it was a great course. Like, it's funny because it's realigning the way we learn, right? It's redoing the way we learn. Honestly, a lot of careers you don't even need to go to college, and that's a whole nother topic. But you can learn like something right now if you want to, and it's just about your drive and the goals you have set. I am a person, and I know you are too, that if somebody doesn't give me the answer, I'll go freaking find it, yes, right? Absolutely. And all these people that say that, oh, I wasn't successful at KW, there's tons of successful people at KW that yes. are making lots of money, right? They're Century 21, Remax, they're successful people. Why? Because they've taken the tools they've gotten, they were given, and they've ran with it, and they made it work for them. And if they didn't get something from them, they went and found it. So it does just comes back to purpose and drive.
Absolutely.
Some people have it, some people don't. And one last hobby is we're taught as kids, you talked about who you hang around, right? We're taught as kids, birds of a feather flock together, right? Yeah. I was always taught, not by my parents, kind of funny enough, is I was taught by mentors when I did a lot of sales and selling life insurance and mortgages and investments. That stuff's hard. Like, I'd rather sell real estate, but they would always say, make sure that your friends are a level above you.
Mm-hmm.
You are who you hang around. You are who you become. And Rich Dad, Poor Dad, like, that is like my life book.
Yes.
And he talks about that. Like, who are you talking to? Are you hanging around poor people that literally have an excuse for everything that's gone wrong in their life? Are you hanging around people that have gone and done it, right? And they're going to teach you iron sharpeneth iron. So that's why I like hanging out with you, is that not only do our conversations go like 2 hours, and it's hard sometimes, but I get a lot of out of it, and I'm like, okay, I don't need to do that. I need to refocus back over here. This was my goal. Okay, she's doing that, so let me tweak this. And that's the thing that people don't give is enough time for the system to work. They're changing every 2 weeks. Oh, I didn't get any results out of that. You know, I didn't get a lot of results the way I thought I was going to with a lot of my lead gen, but in my first month, 60 leads, 5 clients working with them. And I have clients in our or agents in our group who have been licensed almost a year over a year asking, how did you do that? And I told them, they're like, yeah, but how'd you really, like, that's what I did. But you have to keep reevaluating, and they don't like that. Because again, it's back on them. Instead of saying Facebook didn't work for me, or YouTube didn't work for me, or EXP didn't work for me, it's no, I failed, right? They it's just, it's a topic. And you even saw people kind of leave the group because it's kind of sensitive topic, right?
It is. Yes. It
makes you look like, oh,
it's an uncomfortable topic. It's absolutely, it's personal. It's a personal topic, and nobody wants to have somebody told them that you're not looking at this closer enough, harder enough, and you're not taking it personal. And yeah, you're not doing it, you know, in a wholeheartedly way, right? Absolutely. But you know, I don't want it to run too much into it, because we did touch on a lot of things, and I wanted to share this with the viewers. We're going to be doing this is today, Sunday, February 21st. We kicked it off today on Clubhouse. We're going to be on Clubhouse every Sundays and Wednesdays at 8 p.m. Eastern and 7 p.m. Central Time. And please, if you have any questions, comment below in our comment section, but also in our description, we have a link to all of our calendar events, so you can add it directly into your calendar. All the weekly topics are covered, so you can jump in on whichever topics that you want to come in. But if you are a new realtor or soon to be, I encourage you to come to each of the sections, because we built it in a way that is progressing you throughout your first day as a realtor, or even prior to your first day as a realtor, all the way through you crushing it in your first year. And this is a safe space. It's a peer-to-peer session that we're holding, where we want a lot of realtors to come up, and it's not about me and Jacob sharing some of the things that worked for us. It's really about unfolding and taking questions and really figuring out, how do we all arrive at it? How do we really tackle this? So come with your questions, come with, if you have any insights, please come share. And we're going to do our best to have some really awesome guests on a weekly basis. Anything you want to add, Jacob?
No, just if you want to stay in tune with all the videos, we're going to be doing some Zoom calls. Make sure on the website that you scroll down to the bottom and click register. It's not going to like register you into Clubhouse, but it's going to register you into all the alerts that we're going to be sending out, reminders right before the Clubhouse topics, the event calendar, the guests that we come up with every week. Tune in. Like she said, it's walking through. I'm excited about our next topic, which is prior to day one, because you and I kind of did the same thing where we researched what we wanted before we got there. Most people get their license and then go look for the brokerage and other things. We did that from day one. And so we want to share that, because it's a very important step. That's the step that kind of catapults you, right? And so if you're interested in that topic, tune in. We would love to have you. This is so much fun. I just love this energy. I love learning and sharing. And hopefully new realtors, bring a friend. You know, if you need invites, let us know. We'll try our best to help you. But we're excited to be here. And thank you for doing this with me.
Yeah, absolutely. And one more thing, again, if you're not an iPhone user, no problem. Check out our link. We're going to be taking these sessions into, obviously, like these Zoom sessions where we're going to share them on YouTube. We're all going to start having different other sessions with people to kind of take this to another level. And if there's topics that you don't see on there that you want to see, again, get in touch with us, and we'll love to start creating other means of ways to tackle those topics. So thank you so much, Jacob. I loved our session today. We really started off with fire, so I really loved it. See you next time.
See ya. Thank you so much.